trying to talk to folks, but you know a fella that you're wearing a 10-star as long as I have, Ludlow, gets around a big crowd of folks like this, you're kind of obligated to make sure folks behave, yes, sir.
I heard Henry Fonda say the same thing.
Well, and I seen two or three folks at this Wacko Party that I didn't see at that last Wacko Party.
Oh, yeah.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, it's a constantly changing crowd.
Yes, sir. Well, dudes, you got them down in the boiler room till we can check out and see who they are. Yes, sir. One of them was toting a Barlow knife.
Yes, sir.
Claimed he was just going to sit back there and whittle, but I didn't know.
Did you?
No, sir.
Did Freymeyer have any trouble getting by?
No, sir. They got him at that table back there, yes, sir.
Anything exciting going on in Crabapple?
Well, ain't much going on. By the way, Ludlow, I told you that Ted Koppel was Maynard Jackson. Yes, sir.
And we laughed at you, didn't we?
Yes, sir. I told you. Now, there ain't much going on in Crabapple. You know, it's finally quit raining, Ludlow.
Yeah.
I'm trying to get lots of work done, lots of plowing.
Well, are you able to do that with all your duties there?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Well, you know, fellas just got to work from sun up to sundown. Get done what he can.
Get the job done.
Yes, sir.
Yeah,
yes, sir. Sometimes folks call in all hours of night. And the fellas, the sheriff, you just got to get up and go take care of it. Yes,
right.
Sir.
That's right. Plus, you got a new jail. I know you're very proud
of. Yes, sir.
Of.
Well, we've been working on it. You know, termites got the other jail.
Yeah.
Yes, sir. And them prisoners went out through the floor in the middle of the night. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. We got them, though. We got them when they run and chased them out across the yard, and they run in that barbed wire fence.
I got you.
Yes, sir.
I got you. You a lot of your friends here today. People.
Yes, sir. Well, there's a good many of them, you know. I consider just about all these folks my friends.
Well, they are indeed.
Not all of them now.
No, the guy with his hand up here, he doesn't
yes,
care
sir.
For you much. He was telling you.
Yes, sir. You know, this is a room full of nice-looking folks, Ludlow. It
really is.
Yes, sir.
It really is.
Yes,
and the friendliest folks in the world.
Of course, there's a few right ugly ones, but most of them's nice-looking, Ludlow.
Do you know what? What
same ones that was here last time, too. Yes, sir.
What a great lead-in, because I think people thought I was kidding the other day when I was talking about our first annual hug-off.
Yes, sir.
We want to find the ugliest people. People
well, who... I can go gather up a few of them for you right now. Yes, sir.
We're putting together a great list of prizes. And when we find the ugliest person in Wacko Land, then we'll give them a bunch of prizes.
But well, that sounds like a good idea.
I'll tell you more about that in the days to come.
Yes, sir.
We're still putting the prize list together. It's a wonderful thing.
By the way, Ludlow.
Yeah.
Now, we still ain't figured out who it was that's got that cream pie. But we're working on it.
That's right.
Yes, sir.
And you're watching.
I've been to check. There's a couple of folks walking around with a bulge under their coat. Yes, sir. But we ain't figured out what it was.
But I
took one fella around the corner a while ago, but his was a slingshot. Yes, sir.
Shook him down, did you?
Yes, sir.
All right.
Yes, sir.
Well, you gonna stick around for the whole broadcast?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir, Ludlow. I ain't gonna leave you up here by yourself.
Well, good.
No, sir.
How's the new album doing?
Well, yes, we're coming along with it now. We're coming along with it, yes, sir.
They're
gonna do that new one down at that place called Center Stage down in Atlanta.
I heard
yes,
about
sir.
It. I heard
yes,
about
sir.
It. I guess that's already sold out, isn't it?
No, sir. No, sir. They ain't even started yet. No, sir. There's gonna be lots of tickets for this one.
Well, we'll be
yes, sir.
That's
well,
great.
I hope to get lots of the wackos in there, Ludlow. Yes, sir.
And fill that place up.
Yes, sir.
Sheriff, we'll talk to you later. Glad you dropped by, buddy.
Well, I'll be talking at you.
Yes, sir. Sheriff Milton Crabapple. All right, we're gonna go to our telephone now. Some more folks who couldn't be with us. We're going to talk to Bill in Covington on AM 750 WSB. Hello, Bill.
Good morning. I hope you're doing just as fine as the weather is beautiful.
We are wide open, Bill. Missing you. You ought to be here.
Well, I got my car spinning by, and my wife and I have been discussing. I'm glad Milton said he had on his uniform. I've been wanting to put on something so I could kind of stand out in the crowd.
Oh, you stand out.
Yeah, and my wife said, don't wear this, don't wear it. So I figured out what I'm going to do.
What you going to do?
I'm going to put a raisin in my navel and come as a cookie.
All right, well, we'll be able to recognize you. You know, most everybody here today got their clothes on, so you will stand out, Bill.
But what I'm worried about is...
I hope you'll think you stand out, Bill.
What I'm worried about is who's going to take the first bite.
If you came here, Bill, and nobody noticed, that would be very embarrassing for you. Come on by, we'll wait to see you.
I think I'm
going to
hang up now.
All right, buddy. Take care. Take care of yourself, Bill.
You do the
thing.
Love you.
All right, buddy. Thank you, Bill. Bye-bye. Let's talk to Bambi in Morrow. Hello, Bambi.
Well, good morning, Luddy.
You're all over AM 750 WSB. How come you're not here?
Well, I got car trouble.
I see.
And if I get up enough courage, I may still try to come up there.
All right, good.
I mean, you know, I may have to get out on the road and have to stop and call somebody to come and get me.
Call Bozo.
Call who?
Bozo.
Bozo?
Bozo Roberts, record sale.
Okay, all right, I'll do that. I just wanted to say hello to everybody just in case I don't get there.
Well, we hope you do.
Love all of you.
You be sweet. And
y'all see if you can tame it down over there a little bit.
We'll hold it down, I promise.
Okay.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
872-0750 is our number. If you're outside, our toll-free dialing area is 1-800-WSB-TALK. I don't want y'all to think I was kidding about this ugliest person contest, because we're really going to do that. Matter of fact, we're reserving a place at WSB to every year put the ugliest person in our listening area's picture. We're going to call this the Uggorama, and you'll be able to stop by there and see the picture. So, put together a great list of prizes. So, let me just leave it this way. If you're ugly or you know somebody that's ugly, we need their picture. Great, great prizes. We'll by the end of the week or the first of next week, we'll have this all put together for you. 872-0750, 1-800-WSB-TALK. Let's go to Acworth and talk to Elrod on AM 750 WSB. What do you say, Elrod?
Hello, Lolo. How are you this morning?
I'm doing good, old friend. How you doing?
I'm just doing fine. You know, I was really surprised when I heard you carrying on like you're doing. The very idea of putting down ugly people the way you is.
I ain't putting them down. I'm fixing to give them a bunch of merchandise and stuff.
Oh, well, now that's another thing. That's all right.
Some of my best friends are ugly, Elrod.
That's right. Okay. I'm going to be real, real ashamed of you, Lolo, for making fun of the people who can't help being as ugly as they are.
Oh, what I'm trying to do is uplift them.
Oh, that's right.
I mean, you got a sports hall of fame, you know, and you got you got pretty people on television. But who's going to have the Uggorama, the ugly people of the world?
Well, I tell you, I think that is fine. And I got a joke to tell you this morning, Lolo.
Elrod, this is a clean joke.
You know, if I'm telling it to you, Lolo, it's a clean joke.
I believe that from the bottom of my heart.
That's true. All right, here we go. Seems that this young lady was taking a trip on a train one time.
Uh-huh.
And she had her baby with her, and she could not find a place that was big enough for her to sit down and take care of her baby the way she needed to. So she asked the man to please move over, give her some room. And he just screamed when he looked at her baby. And he said, ma'am, I can tell you, you can have the whole seat. That's the ugliest baby I ever saw in my life. He gets up and runs off the train. Well, she's just devastated. She's crying and crying. And here comes a priest. You know, he comes on the train. He says, now, I'm going to take care of you the best I can, young lady, but you're going to have to tell me what your problem is. And she just can't talk. She's so broken up. So finally, he gets up, and he goes up, and he drives out his handkerchief, which she's been using, and he brings it back to her, and he says, now, here's a nice, fresh handkerchief, and I got a banana for your monkey. About had enough of that. I mean,
Elrod, you need to come out here. You're a big hit.
I want to come out and see you, Lolo, but you know, I got to work for a living. If I could just get away around having to work for a living, I'd be having just fun.
Well, you do what all these folks do, phone in sick.
That's a good idea, Lolo. You have yourself a good day now.
All right, buddy. We appreciate it.
Okay, goodbye.
Bye-bye. Elrod from Acworth. It is 18 minutes after 10 o'clock at AM 750 WSB. Welcome back, gang. It is 10:22 now at AM 750 WSB, and boy, we're having fun now. And all our phones are in good shape, 872-0750, 1-800-WSB-TALK. We're doing a live broadcast. The Wackos are here. The Hyatt Ravennia is our location. Come on out. We're right across the street from Bremerton Mall, I think, exit 21 on 285. And we've got a lady with three beautiful children standing right around this this microphone here. Hi, what's your name?
I'm the zoo woman.
All right.
A very infrequent caller, and these three children are the reason why.
All right. I certainly understand. We thank you for coming. What's going on at the zoo?
Well, we've had a family reunion going on this last week, and Uncle from Idaho's been in town, and we've all been together.
All right.
And we just came up here so we could say hello to Grandmama.
Well, I'm glad you did. What's her name?
Jenny.
Jenny, all right.
Say hello to Grandmama, everybody. Well, now they're going to have an acute case of stage fright.
All right. That's all right. Jenny is out there someplace, and she recognizes the silence. Did you think of something to say now? If you'll just speak up, like we can hear you. Go ahead. You, but we're hearing you. Your voice is from. Just talk. Yeah. Just talk.
Hi, Grandmama.
There you go. Hi, Grandmama. All right, you too then.
I'm the zoo baby. All number right. Two, Grandmama.
Your turn. She wants to say hey to Goofy.
All right.
She sees Goofy in the back. You going to say hey, Goofy? No. Well, thank you very much. We enjoy your show very
thank
much.
Thank you. We're glad you came.
Yeah. No.
All right. I want you to tell everybody who you are now.
Freckles.
Hello, Freckles.
Hello.
How you doing? Hello.
Somebody just said saw me in the aisle. See, so well, there's no denying the fact how you got your Wacko name.
Freckles, indeed.
Because I'm full of freckles. Yeah, do you know that there's a lady on apron walking around here with a loaf of bread?
I haven't seen her yet. With a loaf of bread?
She's got a loaf of bread, and she came in with a case. Has it got any fish in it?
I have no idea. You won ahead of me. Oh, I know. They brought me some barbecue by here.
Oh, well, yeah. She had a loaf of bread. I thought maybe she was going to try to feed this multitude with a loaf and some fishes.
I guarantee.
I mean, I've had my bagel. What time do we eat lunch?
Hey, I'd try to fill up on that coffee if I was you, right now.
The thing about trying to fill up on coffee is it don't last. Well, I've had my thrill of the day.
What was your thrill?
I got a hug from Norman Clayton.
Did
you know,
say?
I told you, he's my main heartthrob.
Norman is here. People haven't seen him.
Norman is here, folks. And I got to sit next to Ted Koppel, so I just feel very privileged today.
Yeah, well, a lot of celebrities here, a lot of big stars here.
Right. Well, I'm really surprised on the way in. I just thought sure we'd be doing this remote. I heard that it was 50-something degrees in the mountains, and I just figured surely you stayed up there, and we were going to have this done by remote from the mountains.
Don't think the thought didn't occur.
I don't.
If I could have pulled that off, Freckles, I'd have been.
I'm quite sure you could.
Because as nice as this place is.
Tell me something.
It ain't got no view.
How do you know what time it is?
I'm looking at this clock right here.
And have you got a click button or are we on delay?
No, you're not.
I'm not. You trust me?
You were going to say something dirty.
You never know. You mean you trust me enough?
You came all the way here to spew filth out in front of me. I do trust you.
Do you really?
I do trust you.
Well, I reckon I'll go sit down there.
You want to hear a little inside showbiz?
Sure.
I've never told this story on the air before. I have to tell you. There's a guy that calls more than any of the wackos here. He's been doing this for 15 years. I don't know who he is. You've never heard his voice on the air. Because as soon as I hear him, I bleep what he says and cut him off. I got to tell you a true story. A real sicko. This guy calls and has been calling. Even when I was on another station, and I answer the phone and I say, hello, you're on AM 750 WSB, and this guy says, doo-doo. That's all he ever says. And of course, I bleep it and cut him off the air. He's gone. Now.
But you just said it.
I know. We have equipment now where we could trace his telephone.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. But you see, I feel like I was losing a listener.
Yeah.
if we had this guy put in jail.
Well, afternoon delight, and I saw delight couldn't be here today, so we can't do any gospel.
I know. Y'all got together last year.
We did a little gospel for you last year, but they're not here. So, yeah. But anyway, I'm having a good time with Adam.
We're always glad you. Where's that husband of yours?
John, if you're listening, call in. We're having a good time. He's probably on his way to Nenon.
All right. Well, he should be here.
Yeah, he should.
Nothing like this in Nenon. Against the law down there.
Oh, they have Alan Jackson concerts, though, down
there. All right. All right. We are coming up here on the Freckles. We're coming up here on the news and some commercial messages. We're gonna take care of that, and then we're gonna be right back at the Hyatt Ravennia, talking to some of your favorite wackos. If you're out there, give us a call 872-0750 1-800-WSB-TALK.
To enjoy more mirth and madness with Ludlow Porch on AM 750 WSB. The phone lines are open for you at 872-0750 or 1-800-WSB-TALK. Now, here's Ludlow Porch.
All right, welcome back, gang. It is 10:36 now at AM 750 WSB. We're doing a live broadcast, or as live as we ever get from the Hyatt Ravennia. Wackos are here, having a big time, and we are ready to talk to you. 872-0750 1-800-WSB-TALK. Hello there, young lady. What's your name?
Hi, Ludlow. I'm Terry from Indian Springs.
Oh, yes.
You know, they're calling us all wackos, and that's true. To get up at 4 in the morning and leave Indian Springs and get in that traffic to get here, we gotta be wackos.
Big traffic in Indian Springs in the morning.
No, when you get on that 75 and then 285.
Yeah.
Whew.
All right, I tell you what I want. Did you ever get your lizard problem?
No, that's nothing. Everybody's been asking me if we caught my lizard.
Yeah.
No, sir. We still got that lizard somewhere. Horace keeps telling me it's gone out. It's not. It's there.
How often do you see it?
Well, I see just signs of them. I have only seen them a couple of times, but that was enough.
Why don't you ask Fry Meyer in person and live?
Yeah, I think I'm going to. He's in the back. I got a chance.
I talked to him off there early, and I asked him, and he said the best thing to do is catch him and paint him a red fingernail polish.
Well, I'll tell you, if I could have caught him, he would have been here today. Because I would have made you a present of him.
We're going to be talking to Fry Meyer in a little while. We'll ask him that again.
All right, thanks, Lala.
Good to have you here from Indian Springs. Let's go to our... Thank you. No, good chair. Let's go back to the telephone now and let's talk to Bill on AM 750 WSB. Hello, Bill.
Hey, Ludlow, how you doing?
Doing great, buddy.
Wish I could be there, but I got to be out here selling a few chickens instead.
I understand.
Appreciate the show you did for us.
Well, okay.
Got a little golf joke.
It's a clean golf
joke. Oh, definitely.
All right.
The guy tells his wife about 7 o'clock in the morning, he said, I'll pick up George, we're going to go play 18 holes. And she said, well, good, you ought to be home around lunch and everything will be fine. So about 7, 8 o'clock that night, he comes in. And she said, where have you been? And he said, well, we had a little bit of bad luck. He said, we was on the first tee box getting ready to tee off, and lightning struck old George and killed him. And she said, well, you should have been home early. He said, should have been home early. Did you ever try to play 18 holes that way? Get the ball, drag George. Get the ball, drag George.
All right.
That's all I had to say. I just wanted to call him. Wish everybody a good Monday.
Bill, you take care of yourself, buddy.
See you later.
Good to hear from you. What a wonderfully polite audience. Y'all just gave a big laugh to the oldest golf joke. A lot of people here going to heaven because we have somebody at the microphone here. Hello there, sir. Tell all these people what your name is.
Well, hello, my son. How are you doing?
Luther Phillips hobbled up to this microphone.
Well, you know, that is, you know, you just get along the best you can.
I understand. I understand that you've been here for several days and you actually spent the night here last night.
Hey, well, I've been spent the night here for 10 nights.
Uh-huh.
That's the reason I'm so wore out. And you know what?
What?
Yeah, Buffy run off with a bellboy and I don't care.
Well, You know, I don't know any of the circumstances, but you look at me like you could use the rest.
That's why I don't care.
Ran off with a bellboy.
Yeah. And I keep letting her come back, too, you know.
Do you really?
Yeah.
You're pretty patient with the old girl.
Well, you know how it is. You remember when I used to go down and see her, you know, when she lived not too far from home, don't you? You remember this line, don't you?
Yeah, I do.
Yeah, you know, James used to carry me.
I do remember.
Yeah, James used to carry me down there all the time, you know.
And who brought you back?
Well, it took four of them to come bring me back.
And why? Why did it take
four? Well, because I fight them. I didn't want to come back. I reckon we done milked animal as much.
I think probably I was not the only one who remembered that line. But they were a lot nicer to Bill with his golf story.
Hell, they were that, you know. I thought he was going to tell the one about the man said his wife had been dead, you know. Said, you know, he said she'd been married three more days. Said we'd been married 40 years, you know.
No setup. That's
but
what
it
killed it.
Well, you know, that's what I thought the joke was.
I hope Cyril was here.
Well, he probably is.
All right. Okay. Well, listen, I hope you're not too broke up by Buffy.
Oh, no. I think I'll get over it. You know, she'll come back in a day or two.
What, you gonna have her back?
Sure. You seen Buffy?
She's been unfaithful to you.
Yeah, well, you know, I just don't know. This man's fixing to take a picture. Picture right over here. You want
to smile? We'll pause while you smile.
Yeah, okay. Well, there you go. I'm going with this. But, you know, Buffy's just hard to replace.
I would think so.
Yeah.
I would think so. How would you describe, if you had to describe Buffy in one sentence, how would you describe Buffy?
Breathtaking. I ain't got much breath to start with.
I was about to say, but you know, it doesn't take much to take your breath.
That's right, but...
And they're walking down that aisle.
Well, she gets that, you know, I've been coming up here for an hour. Two rows at a time.
Well, we are glad you're here, and you stick around. People be talking to you because everybody wants to meet.
Well, I'm glad to be anywhere at this age. Well, and I see you, my son.
Take care of your bad self. Lucy Phillips, ladies and gentlemen. USB. What do you say, Bill?
Good morning, Ludlow.
How you doing?
Well, I'm doing pretty well.
Well, good.
Y'all are having a big time, aren't you?
We are having a nice time. Wish you could be here.
You know I ain't got enough air to light. That's one reason I'm not there.
I understand.
Let me ask you something. Did Luther parachute in the nude this morning?
Did Luther do what?
Did he parachute in the nude this morning?
No, he's behaving himself so far.
He's behaving himself so far.
Behaving himself so far. I hear some nervous laughter back in the
back. I'd give anything in the world if I was down there.
Erline is here. That's... And that high-pitched cackle is coming from Brigette.
Lord have mercy.
Bill, you take care of yourself, buddy.
And thanks for letting me talk.
Always enjoy it. Hang in there.
Thanks.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Hobo Bill, we're going to talk to Peanut on AM 750 WSB. Hello, Peanut.
Good morning. I just had to call in and say good morning to you and all the good wackos there.
Well, we were hoping you were going to be with us.
Well, I was hoping so, too. They had some little allergy problems with keeping me from being there, but it's not serious. It's just aggravating.
Oh, I understand.
But I was so glad to hear Luther. I've got a story about Peanuts and Luther.
You have you?
Mm-hmm. There is a young minister that has been visiting him there at the home, getting acquainted with him. And he was visiting with him one day, and he looked over, and beside the table there was a bowl of peanuts.
Maybe
the young minister was hungry, and he'd reach over and get some peanuts and eat them and talk to Luther, and reach over and get some peanuts and eat them and talk to Luther. Came time for him to leave, and he looked over, and lo and behold, the bowl was empty. He had eaten up every one of Luther's peanuts. And he said, gee, Mr. Luther, said, I sure am sorry. I didn't mean to do that. Luther says, that's okay, sonny. Already gummed all the chocolate off of them anyway.
Oh, what?
But I just had to say hi and tell them all how special they are.
You get to feeling better, my love.
Okay.
Take care of yourself.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
All right. It's hardly worth introducing this lady. I think everybody here knows who this is. World's only country western exotic singer. And got more nerve than an abscessed tooth to show up here. Erline P. Bountiful is here. Hello, Erline.
Hello!
only country and western exotic dancer and consummate connoisseur of nakedness as an art form.
Uh-huh.
What's up?
Is it an art form or what?
An art form. Did you look attractive today?
Moi is precious.
Yeah, have you seen Luther?
You mean the one that was drooling down his beard in the back?
The old man with a little spittle coming out of the car. Yes.
Yes, I still haven't forgiven him for last year's little indiscretion.
What did he do last year?
When he got his beard tangled up in one of my pasties going through the revolving door.
I remember that.
And then he had the nerve to have me arrested for assault with a delightful weapon.
Yeah, and then the fire alarm went off for some reason.
You know, Ted Koppel
makes Minnie Mouse sound like a baritone.
Well, you know, I want to plug my book, too.
All right.
Don't say it. Don't even think it. My book is called The Sociological Effects of Stripping and Other Forms of Nakedness Upon the Rise and Fall of Western Civilization.
It's a little bitty book.
A little bitty book. Listen, don't let Ludlow fool you with that conservative air up there. And just because he's got clothes on now, the man can get naked with the best of them.
That's
I'm gonna let him tell you.
Can we take that as an endorsement?
But of course.
All right.
I'm gonna let you tell the story about what you and Bob Mohan did to Wally Kennedy that time.
I will. I'll tell that sometime during the course of the day.
That is the funniest thing I have ever heard.
Like an absolutely true story.
Well, I would like to sing a little tribute to my boa constrictor Rasputin.
Well, I need for you to hold the thought and hold Rasputin, because I've got to take care of some serious business right here.
Well, if you insist.
I do.
Maybe John Presbyterian here can help me hold my thoughts.
No, that's not what John was thinking about holding. More from the Hyatt Ravennia right after this.
Atlanta's Morning News.
All right, let's check in now with our own meteorologist, Kirk Mellish.
Okay, Wackos, for today, partly sunny and warm, high 87, clearing and mild tonight, low 65. Tomorrow, partly sunny, high 89, low 67. With frequent weather updates, I'm meteorologist Kirk Mellish in the AM 750 WSB Weather Center.
All right, it is 73 degrees right this minute at AM 750 WSB, 10:53. We are at the Hyatt Ravennia Hotel. Having a big time. You're not going to believe this, but Erline P. Bountiful is out handing out business cards. Erline, if you want to sing, I think that you handing out business cards is in violation of three laws and at least one commandment I can think about. Now, we're going to... All right. Nice outfit.
I'm little and cute.
Okay, we'll all go with it.
In prices, I am precious.
All right. Now, you got a song for
us? Yeah. This is a song in tribute to my boa constrictor, Rasputin, who is, even as we speak, languishing at home, pouting, brokenhearted, because I have broken up his incestuous and somewhat, I don't know how you should say it, affair with my vacuum cleaner hose.
I think that said it all. Got yourself a dumb snake, Ed.
Anyway, this is called...
This is dedicated to the snake.
Yeah. This is called Cleopatra's Theme. Sparkle, sparkle, little snake, I won't hit you with a rake, or do you in with... with garden hoe, or tell your mama where to go. If you promised I can trust that you won't bite me on the bust.
Erline. Normally we had planned, or Dave Baker had planned, a private ceremony with you to award you this.
Don't let us you got it.
This is your certificate. This is a certify that Erline P. Bountiful is an official Dave Baker Bakette and is dazzled by his magnetic personality and superior production of the Ludlow Porch Show, and is entitled to all rights and privileges thereof, AM 750 WSB, an honorary Bakette.
Dave, would you like to discuss those rights and privileges with me after the show?
Erline P. Bountiful. Erline, thank you. Well, you can spot a Presbyterian every time. John, the Presbyterian, hauling coffee around here for Erline. All right. We're at the Hyatt Ravennia having a time of our life, and who could this be? Hello there. Tell everybody who you are.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. The caller, Joe.
Joe from the Cape. How you doing, Joe? Now, you see, Joe, here's where you should be running for office. How you doing?
I'm doing great.
Good. I've been looking for you.
This is my first opportunity to be at one of our fellowships, and I'm just so happy to be here this morning. I've heard the Wackos for years, and this morning I get a chance to see them. Let me say this. Some peoples may misunderstand me, but it's my goal to make us first. It's my goal to make us first, whether it's WSB Radio, whether it's DeKalb County, whether it's the state of Georgia, whether it's America. It's my goal to make us first. I won't rest until we are first. I feel like this show is extremely successful because of personalities like me.
I couldn't agree more, Joe.
It's like the game of baseball. You got a place for somebody at first base. You got a place for somebody at the bat. And you got a place for the call of Joe. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Joe. It's 10:58 at AM 750 WSB.
Are you still afraid of computers? Why do you stonewall learning about computers? They intimidate you, don't they? And you're still determined to live your life without them. You're going to fold your arms, stick out your chin, and say, I've made it this far, I'm going all the way. Good.
AM 750 WSB presents the Ludlow Porch Talk Show. If you would like to talk to Ludlow, dial 872-0750. That's 872-0750. Now, here's Ludlow Porch.
All right, welcome back, gang. It is 8 minutes after 11 o'clock at AM 750 WSB. Ludlow Porch at the Hyatt Ravennia, and they just keep on coming. I expect it to be some kind of legal action taken against this crowd almost any minute. They are here. We're gonna talk. We're going to talk to one of our favorites. So you heard this lady cackling earlier when she got a look at Erline. She just about lost it. Tell everybody.
Yeah, I need that to stand on.
See, now you don't have to tell anybody. This is British. This is Bridget, the
Don't you make me start.
The cackling English lady. Hello, Bridget. We're glad you're here.
Nice to meet you all.
I knew you were here earlier when I heard you.
Well, that was not my fault. That was Dave's fault. He made me laugh.
Dave was all the way up here.
No, he wasn't. He was back there then. Honest.
Okay. I'll take your word for it. Who all have you met?
Oh, let me see. Madam Zero, of course, and Bloody Mary and Leather Breeches and Nomenclature and Et Al, you know.
They're all here.
They are indeed all here.
Where's your husband? Is he now with
you? He's in the back.
Tony.
Where is he? That's not Tony!
No, that's the guy with his hand up. He always raises his hand.
He's never here when you want him.
There's Tony. Hi. He's here with us. Nice hand for Tony.
He's the one that does all these jobs for everybody else, but never for me.
No shoes for the cobbler's children.
That's right. That's right.
We are glad you're with us, Bridget. You enjoy and try to behave yourself.
I can't behave myself.
Bridget. I understand that Ciro might be on the telephone. Ciro, are you there?
I'm coming to you directly from the BBC.
Yeah.
That's Buddy's by Ciro.
Uh-huh.
The only driving funeral home in the South that I absolutely know anything about.
Yeah.
The official funeral home of the Olympics.
Uh-huh.
The official funeral home of the Wacko Party.
Yeah.
And I just run out of room. I run out of breath.
Ciro, we're glad to have you. How you doing?
I'm doing fine, Poacher. How you doing?
I'm doing good. Everything all right at the BBC?
Yeah, I'm on the way up there.
You're on the way here?
Yeah.
What are you going to do when you get here? Are you bringing the grief ladies?
No, they can't come. We had a real busy morning.
busy doing what? Never mind. I don't want you to answer that.
We had two stand-ups and one flat out.
Did you show up?
Dave don't know what a flat out or stand-up is, does he?
You need to... I think he just let his little imagination go wild. You need to... get caught up, I would imagine, after all this wet weather we've had, that perhaps you're behind.
Yeah, we got way behind.
Anybody wants to drop by and see, could you give some kind of directions or give an address for the BBC? Because I know that you're... it's kind of a unique place.
It's 71113 Forest Park Boulevard.
And for all the folks out there that... This started off simply as a little small business venture. You bought bought an old Burger King.
That's right. We renovated a Burger King, and then we put in a conveyor belt so we could move everybody's body around from one side to the other, you know.
And of course, then you installed the crematorium.
Yeah, we put in the microwave crematorium in the backyard. We call that the crispy critter.
Uh-huh. Or blowing in the wind.
Blowing in the wind, yeah. That was the original name.
Uh-huh.
And, you know, then we put in the car wash and the lube so you can get all that done at the same time.
Yeah. And plus, and always got jalapeno dip.
Always got the jalapeno dip, and sure have.
All right, well, listen, you come on down here, and we'll look forward to seeing you when you get here.
Yeah, okay, Poach, we'll see you in a little while.
All right. Ciro Green.
Your mortician, he understands. That's what about him.
I forgot about that. You take care of your crazy self.
See
you. I'll talk to you. 872-0750 is the number. All right, and I want to remind everybody that you can hear the more than wonderful Wes Minner Show, and you can hear him tonight right here on AM 750 WSB. And tell everybody your name. Go ahead.
Me?
You, yeah, you.
Howdy! Woo, I'm just so proud to be here. I'm Minnie Pearl's cousin, lots of girls. And I'm going to yodel for you. And I'm going to sing a little song that Uncle Nabob taught me a long time ago. First, I'll yodel for you.
All right.
Yodel-a-dee-dee-dee-yodel-a-dee-dee-yodel-a-dee-dee-yodel-a-dee-dee-yodel-a-dee-dee-yodel-a-dee-dee-yodel-a-dee-dee-yodel-a-dee-dee-yodel-a-dee-dee-yodel-a-dee-dee-yodel-a-dee-dee-yodel-a-dee-dee-yodel-a-dee-dee-yodel-a-dee-dee-yodel-a-dee-dee-yodel-a-dee-dee-yodel-a-dee-dee-yodel-a-dee-dee-yodel-a-dee-dee-yodel-a-dee-dee-yodel-a-dee-dee-yodel-a-dee-dee-yodel-a-dee-dee-yodel-a-dee-dee-yodel-a-dee-dee-yodel-a-dee-dee-yodel-a-dee-dee-yodel-a-dee-dee-yodel-a-dee-dee-yodel-a-dee-dee-yodel-a-dee-dee-yodel just want some butterbeans. I can't stand them collard greens. Pass that cornbread if you please, and give me a bowl of butterbeans.
Oh, you can't get that kind of stuff on FM.
That's right. Well, I just want to tell you how proud I am to be here, and so I'm so glad I could come.
Well, we're glad to have you, and I tell everybody that this is Leather Britches, who looks like the picture of health. Leather Britches, but under the weather.
Well, I've been sick.
I know you have, but
but I'm making a comeback.
Looking good, looking good. Nice hand for Leather Britches, if you will. Well, never know she had a sick day in her life. Let's go to the telephones now and talk to Paul on AM 750 WSB. Hello, Paul.
Hey.
How you doing?
Good. How are you doing?
Great.
Do you know how you know when somebody's watching Ludlow?
How's
listening
that?
Listening to him?
How's that?
You ever look at a smile on somebody's face when they're driving down the road?
Oh, that's nice. Thank you, Paul.
I need a Wacko name. Arlene's the only one who can give me one.
Who?
Arlene. She's the only
one. You mean Erline?
Well, yeah. She can give me a Wacko name, though.
All right. Anything you want to use in public?
It's a hardware man. You know, you're getting rid of me. You're selling all these darn air filters and losing me all this business.
Oh, really? You in that kind of business, Paul?
Yes, sir, I am.
Okay. Well, congratulations.
I'm the best there is in Atlanta.
All right, Paul, you take care of yourself.
Wait a minute.
All right.
Do you know who Styles is?
Yes.
Styles?
Yeah, sure.
He lives here.
All right.
He's a good man.
Yeah, great man.
He doesn't know I'm telling you, but he's a good man.
And this audience is fascinated with that information, Paul.
I know they all know who he is.
You take care of yourself.
I bet about 3/3 of them do know who he is.
I expect so. Hang in there.
All right.
Bye-bye, Paul. Bye-bye. We're going to talk to Freckles John. John of Freckles fame. John, are you there?
Well, I tell you what, if it wasn't for Buffy and the grief ladies in the truck with me, I'd get off the board.
Tell Freckles.
We're having a good time, Danny. We're on the way to Callaway.
Uh-huh.
And you can tell Luther and Cyril don't look for them back till the weekend.
All right. That they're going to be tied up till the weekend?
That's right.
I will pass that log to them, I promise.
And one thing, Freckles is bad to steal. You better keep your eye on her.
Is that right?
Yeah. And you took a chance putting a microphone in her hand, too.
I didn't put it in her hand. She came, took it away from Dave Baker.
She's bad about that.
I know that.
I got a question. On this Ugly People contest,
yeah.
Can you send in other people's pictures?
Sure.
I was thinking about Jimmy Carter's children.
Yeah.
I mean, they're eye-watering ugly. You know, they...
Eye-watering ugly.
Eye-watering ugly. You know, it makes your eyes water when you look at them.
Yeah, I understand.
That's kind of like Freckles is in the morning. I have to put on my dark glasses and then...
Let's
go and look at her.
Let me tell you what we're going to... Some of the prizes that we've already put together is going to include a weekend at a beautiful place. I'm not going to tell you where it is yet, but a lot of big prizes. So now's the chance for all the ugly people out there to get to go if you know somebody that's ugly, or if you got stuck with an ugly person, you know.
Well, you got a pretty good collection out there with you right now, you know. Because I know some of them. Yeah, I know what they look like.
But they ain't no winners here. I think the worst we got here today is mildly unattractive, and I believe that old boy left early.
Well, I'm disappointed she didn't sing verse 2 to Butterbean.
Well, she would have.
Well, you need to get her. Verse 2 is really better than the first verse.
All right, listen, I got to get out of here. They tell me that I'm way late, big boy.
Well, I just hope they don't raid you too early so you can have a lot of fun.
I do too.
Y'all have fun.
Hang in there.
See ya.
Bye-bye. 18 minutes after 11 o'clock at AM 750 WSB. Let's check in now with our own meteorologist, Kirk Mellish.
Great weather for a Wacko party. Today, partly sunny and warm, high 87. Clearing and mild tonight, low 65. Tomorrow, partly sunny, warm, and more humid.
All right, we're at the Hyatt Ravennia, broadcasting live. It is 11:23 on AM 750 WSB. If you're out and about, come on by and join us. We have a contingent in front of us of several people, and it seems to be headed up by Warren Peace. Warren, welcome. How are you?
Well, a gracious good morning to you, sir. How are you?
I'm fine. How are you doing?
Listen, this is my entourage here against the daylight savings time. You know, I have this campaign going on against it. I think it's a conspiracy between the governments of the cities, because this extra hour that they put in this daylight saving time, folks, is right in the middle of the day. It's in the middle of the day, and it's going to burn up the crops. They have to sell more water. They have to sell more fertilizer. It's a conspiracy, folks. You got to understand that. We got to do something about it. And
pull yourself together. We're going to take up a collection here, Warren.
I'm sorry. I just get beside myself. But I've got this group here that we're going to sing.
Now, what did you call them? You said they were what now?
The seldom heard of.
Entourage.
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 Uh-huh.
Yeah, that's French for
herd. That's a bunch of folks. That's a bunch of folks.
So what are y'all going to sing?
What?
Yeah, y'all need to.
We're going to sing "You Are My Sunshine," very apropos to the daylight saving time, don't you think?
Well, you want to introduce the folks.
Yeah, funny how time slips away.
Yeah, funny how time slips. The singing lawyer is on guitar. Madam Zero is going to try to sing. Bloody Mary is on bass. The Dread Pirate Roberts is second bass. John the Presbyterian is here. And Dark Dust Vader. Dust Vader is here. So, folks, without further ado, here we go. Lawyer, if you please.
You are my sunshine, my only sunshine. You make me happy when skies are gray. You'll never know, dear, how much I love you. Please don't take my sunshine away.
Everybody.
Thank you, Warren. Thank you, Warren. Pathetic at best, but they win our pathetic award. But
hold it for me one time.
We got something for the singer. The singing lawyer's going to do something?
Yes, sir. I'm going
to
do this.
I don't want you to be shy. Just jump up here and do this.
I'm just going
to
do this for Luther. This is Luther's favorite song.
A request.
You know how Luther is about love?
Yes.
This is just a little loving. It goes a long, long way.
Okay.
Now just a little loving will go a long way, and you'll make me happy the rest of my day. Put your arms around me and I'll be your slave, 'cause just a little loving will go a long way.
All right, nice hand for that. The singing lawyer. And I see here that somebody has adjusted this microphone. I'm expecting Sam Marcel in here any minute, apparently.
No, you were supposed to come in a little bit.
There you go. All right, we're gonna go right to our fold, because I understand the Choo Choo Man is with us on AM 750 WSB. What do you say, Choo Choo?
Hello, Ludlow.
Hello, buddy.
And hello out there, all the Wackos. I know y'all have it, bud, down there.
We are having big time, and we were hoping, even up until the last minute, that you're going to be able to slip away and be with us.
Well, I can't make it, buddy.
I understand.
But I'm there in spirit. Buddy, I'd like to be there with you.
Well, you'll catch us next time. I know it.
Well, I'm going to do my best. I want to congratulate Erline on that big award she got. She just won.
Oh, yeah. Well, she certainly deserves that. Congratulations.
I noticed.
If anybody deserves the big award, she does.
Oh, that's. Yeah. I noticed nobody had done that. And, maybe they had down there, but I hadn't heard it on radio.
Well, Choo Choo, we're missing you, buddy, and I hate to rush you, but the clock is ticking away on me.
Buddy, y'all have fun, and I'll catch you sometimes the last part of the week.
Look forward to it, buddy.
All right.
Bye-bye. Bye. One and only Choo-Choo Man, who hadn't missed one of these things in a long time, and he would have been with us, except he got a little sickness in the family. So we wish everybody at Choo-Choo Man's house a quick recovery. It is...
The phone lines are open, and you can join the fun with Ludlow Porch on AM 750 WSB. Dial 872-0750. That's 872-0750. Here's Ludlow Porch.
All right, welcome back, gang. It is 11:36 at AM 750 WSB. Ludlow Porch from the Hyatt Ravennia, and the Wacko broadcast is in full tilt. And boy, we're having fun now. We're going to go to our phones and take a few telephone calls, and we'll get back to the Wackos who are live and in person. We're going to talk to Julia Childs. Julia, you're on AM 750 WSB. Hello, Julia.
Hey.
Julia, why aren't you here?
Oh, no. I'm sauteing Mommy's sweetbreads.
No, let me tell you why you're not here.
Oh, why, no?
Julia, because you don't have the nerve.
You're got
food. Well, listen, I was looking forward to introducing you to this this vast radio audience and these live folks here today.
Well, I'm live too, Ludlow.
Okay, well...
For you.
What is your question?
I went to a store the other night that sells package goods.
Sells what?
Package goods. Liquor, Ludlow. Liquor, damn it.
liquor store. You went to a liquor store. Okay.
And the man there said, when I asked him about the cost of my liquor, he said, that costs so much because of the sin tax. Now, Ludlow, I thought syntax was how you put a verb and a noun together.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. Well, so anyway, explained that the syntax was this tax you pay when you want to be bad.
Yes.
Yes. And I was thinking maybe we could raise the tax up even more and really do something outrageous. Yes. I mean, if you have to pay that much for booze, just think how much you'd have to pay to really do something naughty.
Julia, I don't want to talk about it.
I know you do. You just want to do it, Ludlow. Well, Ludlow, toodaloo.
And a toodaloo to you, too.
Well, toodaloo your own little loo, I'll tell you.
Take care. Bye-bye. Let's talk to Ernie on AM 750 WSB. Hello, Ernie. Ernie? Ernie's not there. Ernie.
Hello. Two short questions.
Okay.
One is easy for you. You were speaking of ugly persons. What about that guy in Fraser of the Sierra Madre who said, badgers... We ain't got no badgers.
Yeah.
We don't need no stinking badgers.
Yeah.
What was his name?
His name was Arturo Godoy.
No, that is not correct.
No, I'm sorry. Alfonso Bedoya, different guy.
Correct. And the line was used again in Blazing Saddles.
Yes.
The second question. This is one that has been driving Candler Park crazy, and no one can answer it. I thought perhaps you might. What was the name of Papillon Cassidy's horse?
Topper.
Topper?
T-O-P-P-E-R, Topper.
Well, I'll be darned. And he wore the Bar 20 brand.
Well, yeah, wore the Bar 20, that's right.
Well, thank you, Ludlow.
You are welcome, Ernie. You take care of yourself. We'll be talking to you. 872-0750, 1-800-WSB-TALK. And I understand Norman Klatcher is with us. Is Norman on the telephone? Is that where we are? Norman, can you hear me?
Hey, old Lud.
Norman, how you doing?
I'm doing fine. How are you?
I'm doing great. I was hoping you were going to be here live.
Well, I tried, but you know how it goes.
Like you sprung a leak there, Norman.
I'm doing all I can on my end.
Sounded like it. I don't want to talk about it.
Well, I got mad. They wouldn't let me bring Blue.
Yeah, well, you can, this is a nice place. You can't bring a pig in here.
Well, why not? He don't know he's a pig.
But we would know.
Hey, he thinks he's a dog.
You got your first rim shot even before you got to your material.
Well, I didn't hear the rim shot.
You can't. Well, no, you won't be able to hear.
Oh, is that right? Well, yeah. How will I know whether it's funny or not?
I'll just tell you when it's all over with. You got another rim shot, see?
Well, that's good. I need me some earphones.
All right, you ready? You sure do. You ready?
Yeah, I got a few for you.
Philosophy from the pen of Norman Clatcher. Go, Norman.
Yeah, a bachelor's a man who has no children to speak of. My kids are living beyond my means.
Oh.
You're getting old if you get more excited over a filled prescription than a filled sweater.
You're driving Maurice crazy. He loves this.
Am I going too fast for him?
He loves this.
And your memory is the second thing to go. And only God can make a random selection. And the only permanent thing in life is change. That's a little deep.
Well, Maurice is not through yet. Just, all right.
The only time two can live cheaply as one is when they have a split personality.
Or if one of them don't eat.
And I'm living proof that it's never too late. The squeaky wheel does not always get the grease. Sometimes it gets replaced.
Wow. That's deep. I like that one. Maurice is knocking himself out, and y'all can't even hear him.
Most people are not that wonderful. I'm thankful for people like me. It's better to sit tight than drive in that condition. All right, I got one I'm going to finish up with here.
Wait a minute.
We got the gong?
Now.
Yeah, a good marriage is when both partners think they got better than they deserve. You ready for me to close it out?
Yeah, not a minute too soon.
All right. Whatever else you do today, make sure that... I'm about to use your line there. Whatever else you do today, make somebody happy and mind your own business. Been an absolute pure pleasure on my part.
It has been our pleasure entirely.
Norman Clayton. Good day.
Good day, Norman. And Norman just got a sitting ovation from this magnificent crowd. with the clipboard stepping to the microphone here.
Excuse me, I'm looking for Mr. Port.
Hello there, I'm Ludlow.
Do you have any identification to prove that, sir?
Yes, I do.
Could I see it?
I've got a coffee mug with my name on it.
Oh, that's good.
Yeah. You with the hotels?
I'm with security here at the hotel. I'm Percy Goodlow.
Percy Goodlow.
And we're going to have to ask you folks to leave now.
Why is that, Percy?
Because you don't have permission to be in here after noon. The room was booked from 9 to noon by those people with headphones.
It's 9 to 1, Percy.
No, I'm sorry. We have some ladies who are coming in for a luncheon now. You'll have to leave.
What group?
I'm happy to report today that half of the perpetrators are in custody now. Start out, it seems that one, Cyril T. Greenberg, alias Cyril the Bond, alias BBC, alias The Undertaker, was smuggling buckets into empty coffins into Crabapple.
I'm shocked.
So was I. But you have to admit, Ciro looks real guilty.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, guilty of everything he's accused of and a lot more. Yeah.
This crime was accomplished with the aid of Dude, one of the sheriff's main men.
Yeah.
Also known as Hey Dude and Yo Dude.
It ain't my dude, maybe your dude.
Also, it has come to the attention of this agent that an alleged postal worker was involved. One Stormin' Norman, alias Zip Code Willie, alias Tornado Tom, alias Norm the Storm. It seems that he was in process of running off counterfeit postal stamps for the times when they had to ship the coffins through the U.S. mail.
That's big business.
Yes, sir. But I want you to know that what we've done is we found that you are also involved.
Bless your heart. I wish I had time to let you tell me about it.
You're under arrest. So
but we're right on top of the news at AM 750 WSB.
Hi, Ravennia. The Wackos are here. It is 12:37, and we're going to quickly tell everybody that they will be here till 1 o'clock. And hope you'll drop by. You still got some time. We got about 30 minutes. So let's get right down to our in-house microphone and talk to our present Wackos. Hello there. Tell everybody about you.
This is Haney from Bold Springs. How you doing this morning, Ludlow?
I'm doing fine, Mr. Haney, and aren't we glad to have you here?
I just want to say that it's an honor to be in the presence of such greatness. It's you know, I was talking to Van Note earlier this morning, and I thought my knuckles were going to drag the ground, and felt like my feet were getting real big, and you know, things like that happen when I get around people who are famous.
I see.
You may be interested to know, too, that I'm seeking honest employment.
Are you sure that?
Yeah. Trying to kill bugs for a living.
Uh-huh.
Sooner or later, something's going to pan out. I've got confidence.
Well, if you want it to pan out, you ought to try being a nurse.
That's real good. That's you know, I thought about that.
Did you?
I guess I'll stick with killing bugs right now. So.
I bet you big enough to kill them.
Well, you see these boots I have on, I can really get in the corners.
You got the little ponytail cowboy boots.
That's right, and I have some that are sharper than that. Really get in the corners and what have you.
Well, you probably do the greatest Pat Buttram around. Anybody since Pat Buttram, and we appreciate you bringing your entire mouth here with you, James.
Well, like I said, it's an honor to be here, and I'll step aside and give someone else the microphone.
We love it. Thank you.
Thank you.
Mr. Chaney. All right, you're next. Step right up here to this microphone, my friend.
Hello, Ludlow.
Hello.
The Daredevil.
Hey, big boy, how you doing?
I just got back from Niagara Falls. I knew you couldn't make it there. You were probably busy, so I picked this award up for you. It says, on June 3rd, 1990...
Incidentally, I was not busy. I could have gone for an all-expense-paid trip to Niagara Falls and got that award myself.
Huh? It was a tough job, but I took care of it. It says, on June 3rd, 1991, Ludlow Porch was inducted into the Daredevil Hall of Fame. Now, the Niagara Review reported that Ludlow Porch... Let me start over again.
Okay.
The Niagara Review reported that Ludlow Porch is the Daredevil of talk radio. And the Niagara Falls Gazette said that it says, on June 3rd, 1991, the last of the Niagara Daredevils inducted Ludlow Porch into the Daredevil Hall of Fame. And it's a beautiful plaque with a picture of a barrel on it. And we're proud of Mr. Ludlow Porch, who is one of our brothers now, in the Daredevil Hall of Fame. Thank you, Ludlow.
Thank you, my man. All right. Thank you. Thank you. My friend, the Daredevil. That's very, very nice.
The Daredevil Hall of Fame. It's a barrel, but it looks a little bit like a pot, and I needed a pot because a lot of times I say, Ludlow, you ain't got a pot. And so I thank you very much. That is very nice. Now, someone else approaches the microphone. What kind of plaque do you have for me?
Oh, well, hello, Ludlow.
Hello, Goop. Hello, Goop. How you doing?
Oh, terrific. How about yourself, big boy?
I'm doing great.
I knew that.
And you made it all the way up here from Disney World.
Boy, I'll tell you. You know that quail fellas down there?
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
What a sorry sight. They shut down the park for him.
Uh-huh.
I told the mouse, you deal with it, I'm gone. Hey, you're pretty good at trivia, aren't you?
Well, I don't know. If...
Well, you know the 101 Dalmatians?
Yeah.
What was the 23rd one's name?
Fred.
You are pretty good at trivia.
Goof. I'm a little overwhelmed by your hat. Turn around and show this audience that.
Well, you know, you got to have some kind of a something. Everybody got to something.
I want the audience to see this hat, complete with goofy ears and everything.
With the limo, we ran into Koppel. His limo parked in my limo spot.
Really?
Yeah. Not anymore.
Uh-oh.
Bozo Roberts. Yeah, we go back a long time.
Bozo was here early, but he had to leave before we got a chance to talk to him.
I know it.
Goof, I'm glad you came by, buddy.
Well, thanks for stopping.
Take care.
Come see me in Disneyland.
We need to walk you between breaks or anything?
Now that you mention it, check your tire.
You know, you know how you are. All right, and here she is. June Bug is with us. Hello, June Bug.
Hey, Don. Boy, what an act to follow.
Yes. Impossible.
No, I'll tell you, isn't this a great day, though? We've had a marvelous time.
We've had a great time.
Just great. And we want to thank WSB and you for having all the wackos together. And we have a lot of young wackos. You know, everybody thinks wackos are old fogies.
Who thinks that's not true. Who thinks that?
Oh, well, you know, wackos, they think they've been around a long time and all that. But to all of our people here, we appreciate it so much. And it's been a pleasure being wackos all the number of years that many of us have. We welcome all the new ones. And I'll tell you, I had a real nice surprise a while ago. I told my little daughter, I said, you know, Dave from Conyers, she works over at Honey Creek Golf Club. And I said, I want you to meet Dave. A while ago, I was telling him about Renee. He says, I know Renee. So now I have something real exciting to say when I get home today. But really, though, we think of all of our wackos, Herbie, Bambi, all of them, Choo Choo Man, all of them that are not here. And, of course, we'll always remember our Sparky. So all of you that are not here, you're here in spirit with us.
Junebug, thank you.
Again.
Well said. Thank you. Junebug. All right. You know, and we are... And we are greatly honored because, as you know, the Olympics are on their way to Atlanta, and we are fortunate enough today to have the man who will be the voice of the Atlanta Olympics. Tell everybody what your name is.
Just, I am the voice of the Atlanta Olympics. I am Bob Martinez.
Bubba. You're going to be...
Hello.
You're going to be doing all the play-by-play?
Yes, I would be doing the weightlifting. I would be doing the running and the jumping and the throwing and all that stuff. You know, I'm doing... Because I am, you know, I am starting my own network for the Olympics in 96, Jay.
Last thing I heard, you were coaching.
Oh, no, and now I'm going to be in broadcasting now.
Really?
And, Jay, I'm going to be on the BM network. You take it from there, it's your line. Home run ball, that's called a home run ball.
I would
make it up.
I wouldn't. You know, I was just handed a note a few minutes ago to do a Bell South promo, and it said BS promo. And my thought was, my promos are all, never mind, I don't want
that. That's right, yeah, well, this is a whole different thing with the BM.
Well, And what does that stand for? Bubba Martinez.
Jake, you got it there. That's it, Jake. Very sharp. You are very sharp. You might be my sidekick on this network television thing.
Oh, really?
Because by then, the gig at WJB would be over.
WJB?
Jake.
I was glad that they selected you, because we kind of consider you a hometown boy.
Well, that's right. And I think it's only fair after the shafting that I got from Ted Turner. And
what shafting did you get?
Well, you know, I told him I would do all the sports, and I, you know, I'd get rid of some of those people that he got, and I would do the sports, and he said, get out of here, and, you know, that was, and then I caught him, to caught him, Jay. He didn't like, you know, I mean, I always, when I broadcast, I have to have Julio with me.
Yes, tell everybody who Julio is.
Julio is my rat. And but he's a nice rat, you know. I mean,
as rats go,
Jay, those little teeth and everything.
Well, how long before you will start to bone up on all the rules, because everything from weightlifting to you name it.
I know all that stuff already, so it's okay. We'll start doing Olympic previews very soon.
Well, I need to go to a commercial.
Okay, well,
I want you to do this. I want you to sign off the way you always sign off when you do a sports event.
This is Bob Martinez saying, if you can't play a sport, the hell with it.
Thank you, brother. Bubba Martinez, it is 12:47 now at AM 750 WSB.
All right. Let's check the weather and the traffic now on AM 7.
And from the WSB Skycopter Sky.
Now we got another gentleman at the microphone here at AM 750 WSB. Hello there.
Oh, hello. I'm Kennesaw Kid. I call you a few times on the road.
Indeed.
And I was sent down here. We hear the Ludlow Porch reruns on Saturday and Sunday nights on the road up towards Memphis.
Yeah.
And all the truck drivers want to know who in the world Bloody Mary is. And I've been sent down here to find her.
Well, did you find her all right?
I saw her a while ago. I wasn't introduced to her, though.
Well, where?
The truck's waiting outside.
Is Mary still here? That's Mary right here.
No, that's not him.
She was back in that corner.
Yeah, she was back in that corner a few minutes ago.
She's a real celebrity up that way between Birmingham, Tupelo, Mississippi.
She's a celebrity here, too. But is that Mary? Somebody's pointing. Mary, if you're here, raise your hand. No, I don't think she's still here. Glad
you
can.
We enjoy listening to the show, and a lot of wackos get listened to it late at night on reruns. They may not realize that, but hear it all over the country. There.
Well, you see if you can book Bloody Mary into the Tupelo Tupelo restaurant there or something. You'll teach those folks how to drink.
Yeah, they want me to get a picture of her while I'm here, but we're not going to put it up in no bathrooms or anything like that.
Oh, heavens no. Well, she may still be here. Check around. If she is, she don't want to be involved with you, because I don't see her sticking her hand in. So.
It's my first Wacko Party. I really have enjoyed it.
You come back and see us, buddy.
Thank you.
Thanks to me. All right. Now, I understand Radiator and Edner are on the premises. Ray, are you there?
Aha, Dave.
Hello, Ray.
Boy, we're having fun now.
We're having a big time. How you doing?
Where you been?
Well, we've been right here. Been waiting for you all day.
Well, I was able to come, but Edner came.
Well, why?
She's mad at Kurt Mellis, too.
What's she mad at Kirk about?
Because he didn't make it rain.
Oh. Well,
if it had rained, she could have come to the Wacko Party.
After all that money you spent at the Robo.
$3.25.
Outrageous. And she still didn't make it.
And that's with the wax job, too.
All right. Well, what else is going on?
Nothing. We've just been working.
Well, I'm glad you called.
You want to come out and fix my truck?
You have trouble with your truck?
Yeah, always having trouble with the truck.
What's wrong with the truck?
It's just broke down. The chainsaw won't go. I just come up here to see if I could fool around with your wife, and I can't find her.
She was here earlier. I was trying to. I had a big announcement I wanted to make to you. You know what we're gonna have on Wednesday?
What's that? What are we gonna have on Wednesday?
Wednesday, we're gonna have a man who claims to be from outer space.
I want to talk to him.
Well, y'all have a lot in common.
I think he's canned Edner.
But sure enough. Now I want y'all to be listening, because that'd be Wednesday at 11 o'clock.
a man who claims to be from outer space.
I thought we was fixing to do a J&R commercial.
No, no, no. No, but I got you to help me with that promo.
Anytime.
All right. Well, you through?
I'm done.
I can't wait for you to get into something, Ray.
Well, I've been in something all morning. That's the reason I'm trying to get out of it. And Erline's been messing with me. That's something else.
Yeah, she showed up. Well, I'm just glad that your bride is not
here. I'm glad Edna ain't here.
Well, you take care of your bad self.
Remember one thing, would you?
What is that?
You got a friend in the pulpwood business. Depend on it. We'll see y'all.
Radiator. And another gentleman steps to the microphone. Hello, sir.
Well, just a brief announcement to let you know that this has been a simulcast broadcast direct from Tarpaulin Gap in Wyoming. Yes, you're on the air, Ludlow Porch in Tarpaulin Gap, Wyoming. Go ahead. You're on the air, funny man, Ludlow Porch. Go ahead.
We're on the air, Tarpaulin Gap.
We're on the air in Tarpaulin Gap, Wyoming. Wonderful. Wow. Yes, it has been a simulcast. We've been keeping that quiet, but now it can be told.
Well, listen,
it can be told. It's Dave Lockwood here. You're on the air with Dave Lockwood. Go right ahead.
I'm coming.
Yes, you're on the air where we're playing the Fix to Click. Yes, we are, the big Fix to Click. Wonderful Wack. Go right ahead. Ludlow Porch, the funny man from Atlanta, Georgia.
We've had a nice time being with all the folks in Tarpaulin Gap. Yeah,
certainly have. It's been our pleasure.
How much power does the...
With 50 big-time watts of broadcasting, 50 watts of big-time power here in the Tri-Cities area.
And when at night, you get all the way out of that parking lot.
That's right. Just the cars are lined up out there, and we're playing the wonderful Wax to Watch.
That's right.
The Pigs to Click and the Wax to Watch. That's right. Got you there. Well, it's been wonderful being here, and it's been wonderful having you here. And it's been wonderful being on the air. So stay tuned. I see by the old clock on the wall that it's about 14 minutes past the big hour. 72 degrees warm.
Sit down, shut up, okay? David Lockwood, Tarpaulin Gap, Wyoming. Got to get out of here, gang. We have had a big time. I want to thank everybody who came today. And all you out there, listen. So thanks a million. I'll be right back with you in the morning. Same time, same station. As I said, in the meantime, won't you do me a favor? Whatever else you do today, you find somebody to be nice to.